This is the application for the eufy Permanent Outdoor Lights E22. We're on the main page here. Before we get into the actual cool stuff that the LEDs can do, we're gonna talk about the app overall. Upper right-hand corner, this plus sign, this is how you'll actually add something to here. So if you have more lights, that's how you would do it. Over here, there's gonna be user information, things of that nature. Down here, devices, schedule, and then Lumiolo link. I am saying that horribly wrong, but these are very cool in that one, if I come here, they have schedules. And I created a schedule that every day at 1800 to 6 a.m., if I come in here, if it detects somebody on a specific device, it will light up my lights, which is awesome. But then you also have these. These are predetermined holiday lights that are these days, during these times, if you turn this on or off, it will allow you to run this specific scene on your lights without even having to set something up yourself. It's really cool. The fact that this is here and that you can add your own is great. You want to add your own, you come up here to the plus sign for schedule, and then you would create a name, create a date that it would run through, create the time, and then if you have a device trigger. So if I come here, that's what I want. So there's my devices, and I can set my mood. I'm not going to set one up this time. And then we have custom, so I can add a schedule, very similar to what I was doing before. And that's all under our scheduling. If we come over here to our link, this one is really cool in that I have fire lights. What this will do is if one of my S3 Pro cameras picks me up, it will turn my lights on red at 78% so that I can kind of walk past my fire pit, maintain my night vision and not be blinded.
Around the corner there, hard to see in the dark, it's not focusing, but there's a camera. And that camera, once it picks up a person, tells the lights, once I get them to focus, to turn on red. That is the fire thing that I set up so that I don't kill my night vision.
However, let's say we want to do a different setting. I would add an interactive scene, and we're just going to call this test and then devices. Well, we're going to say what is going to trigger this. So I'm going to say either one of my S Pro cameras and select confirm. And then what happens? Well, my lights here will be the actuation. And then what are we going to do? Well, I can select any one of those scenes that we talked about, but also that I'll show you a little later. But what I want is white lights to come on, and then I could set the brightness anywhere from 100% to 1%. I'm doing this so I can see what's going on. So I'm gonna say 98%. Then I can select, when do I want this? I can set up a daily routine, or I can set up a specified date range. So just like the 4th of July, Father's Day, things of that nature. I'm gonna say this is a daily routine, but it's only gonna be on the weekends, and select confirm. And then what time? This, I feel, could use a little fixing, because you have to select. And then I could say sunrise, sunset, but if I wanted to make a change, I have to come into customization and then select save, and then go back to come in here and do customization, and we'll save for 6 a.m. And then lighting duration, how long do I want this to stay on? Well, since this would just be to help me get into my house, I'll say 2 minutes and then confirm, and then up here, save. So we've just configured another lighting scene that will use a camera to tell what's going on. And you could toggle these on and off as you want. Coming back to our devices tab, if I select into my device in the upper right-hand corner here, this is our settings for this. There's not a lot of settings to go over. So here you can see the power status, the length of the string that I'm currently using. I have 15 meters, which is just shy of 50 feet. If I need to add to this, I can. And then I simply power down and power up the light string, and it will figure out how long it actually is. That's really cool, because I started off with just testing with two and then added more. And then here we have lights disabled setting. This is an awesome feature, which I have to turn on the lights for, but it will allow you to black out any lights that you don't want actually lit up. So if you have this going up the side of your house and don't want those lit up, you can select, don't do this one, don't do this one, don't do this one, don't do this one. And notice right here, there is the power indicator, and then it goes. So one is always going to be the LED closest to your power source. And then you can select save if that's something you want to actually use. Here we have installation space. This is just letting it know where it's actually going to be put into place. And then we have music flow. What this will allow you to do is, based on music, it will allow the lights to blink based on sounds and things. And you could specify different cadences and brightness. I'll show you what that looks like here. After music flow, we have general. This is going to be the name of your device, the Wi-Fi connectivity, a mounting guide if you haven't gone through that already, and then about this device, sensitive information in there, won't be showing you that, and then firmware. If you need to upgrade your firmware, that's where you can come to do it. But now we come to the really important part of this, the cool thing that the eufy permanent outdoor lights can do, and that's all this. Let's take a look. Here we have the important screen of our application, which is actually the control for the lights that you're seeing in the back. Right now it's on 100% and turned on and just randomly cycling through stuff. This magic dice roll right here, if I select this, it will randomly send a scene to the lights behind me. And you can see on the application itself, it actually gives you a fairly good idea of what the scene will look like on your home. It does wrap around to the back, so there is more going on back there. But here, if I do the magic dice roll again, it will send another random pattern to the house. And if I like this for whatever reason, I can select the save icon right here, so it's something that I can come back to later, or I can select edit and it will allow me to make changes to the particular random thing that was sent back there. Now we have light show mode on, which is this infinite icon right there. If you don't want that, you could turn that off. But here we have one more throw of the dice. And you can see it's a little more subdued in its coloration. Now you do have inspiration text, as they call it, down here, where you could pick something to get inspired by, or you could select the AI light chat, which will allow you to tell it something and have it create it in a pattern. So in my case, I'm going to do a space battle and select generate. And now the AI is coming up with its own idea of what this should be. Now it is doing a moving pattern around there in the corner, and that feels very, very 4th of July-ish, but that's okay, because we can come in here and make changes to this. And if I do something like generated for New York Jets right there, and it is showing green with a little hint of blue in there, not entirely sure why, but there you go. And now we're going to try text destroying the One Ring, because I'm trying to avoid all sorts of copyright. So there we go. This is what AI would determine destroying the One Ring would look like. So you can have some fun with this in creating your own scenes via AI. It is not as much of a gimmick as I thought it would be, and you can get some cool inspiration from this if you wanted to, but that's all under this all section right here. If you wanted, you can select ambient, and then from here, there are preset ones for holiday, season, special events. So we're coming up on Halloween where I am. So if I come in here, this is one of the Halloween themes. And then this is a second Halloween theme. So it's a little more orangey. And third Halloween scene. So you got purples and oranges in there. And then if you're into Christmas or maybe St. Patrick's Day, there's lots of options. But the holidays is only one of them. You also have seasons. So I could say, here's winter, bright white lights, things of that nature. Early autumn, you're going to have oranges and things like that. But you have events as well. So you can pick, what do you want? Well, here, show me some barbecue lighting. Well, there we have barbecue lighting. Maybe we want a birthday party. And there you could see all the lighting in the background there. You also have emotion. So how are you feeling? So let's say I'm feeling warm. So it's going to show you kind of a warm pulsating light right there. Maybe I'm looking for soothing. You're going to see greens and things of that nature now. But you can see just how bright it is lighting up the side of my house. Here we have healing. So we're going to say sunset glow, showing you not the car driving past, warm fireplace. So there's lots and lots of options. You want to do something like a flag? Well, here you go. What do you want? They got a few flag options. So here we're going to do United States. So this is going to be should be red, white, and blue, but it's starting around the back there. Here we have for children, if there's a specific thing that you'd like. So here we have Magical Academy, avoiding all sorts of copyrights, much like I was before. There you go. Fantasy Castle. So lighting all around there. And then last but not least, they actually have pre-programmed weather ones. And here we've got a rainy situation. So here's one of my personal favorites, which is the thunderstorm, which would make an excellent addition to the Halloween theme. So there you could see all that just under the ambient. Now, they do have settings for daily. And what that's going to do is that's going to allow you to do steady on. So there's your warm glow. Here is your cool white. And notice just how much it's showing over there on the side. And I'll show you in a moment what white looks like. And you can see this brightens things up quite a bit. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm actually going to turn these off so you can't really see what's going on the side of my house here, but I'm talking using lav mic, so you should still be able to hear me. And this is roughly where it is. And if I turn it on, you can see the difference. Now notice it goes into a weird mode first, but then here's our white, cool white, warm. So it brightens things up. This is all at 100%. It brightens things up so much that you can use these not only as a seasonal light, but you can use it as like a spotlight to help keep an eye on things that are happening around your house. Now, the last option that we have right here is personal. And if we come into personal, this will allow us to make changes to our lights. So right there, you could see I just did two lights, and maybe I want that one and that one. You see them turning on over there? I'll make the closest one over there turn red. You can select individual lights that you want to turn on. You can create your own patterning. Notice right now I have it on the steady, but if I wanted to, I have a moving pattern. I have a strobing pattern, cycling, starlight, which will just fade them in and out, twinkling, and then a breathe. And I'm not turning on a lot of them, so you kind of actually see what's going on. And then you have, if I come back up to this one, they have an effect speed. So there we go. I'm really moving things along with that. And then if I come back to our daily really quick and put on our warm, can show you the difference of intensity. So if I turn down the intensity, you get an idea. Don't have to have them blaring as bright as they are all the time. But that is everything that you can do for the eufy Permanent Outdoor Lights E22 using the eufy Life app. One more magic dice roll, because I really enjoy using it because it comes up with some weird things. And that definitely could be one that I could use for Halloween. One more dice roll, because it's very addicting to do. So I will leave you with that as an example of what's capable using the application and this light string.